Eye Glaucoma Presents, a video series sponsored by Allergan, Glaukos, Ivantis, Nova Eye, and Sight Sciences. I'm your host, Dr. Constance Okeke, glaucoma specialist and cataract surgeon, and we're here to get to the point and share surgical learnings and pearls in MIGS. In today's video, the MIGS device being featured is the OMNI Surgical System by Sight Sciences. One of the most common challenges seen with this procedure, and really any MIGS surgery, is proceeding with poor visualization during surgery. Angle surgery is all about being able to obtain a good view. Corneal striae created from too much pressure of the gonio prism on the surface can make the initial tip insertion behind the TM or the tracking of the catheter difficult to see. One suggestion is to fill the AC with viscoelastic right before the entry of the OMNI and in between passes of the inferior and superior angle if more than one hemisphere is being treated. Also, mind your dominant hand and try to keep it lifted up so as not to create significant loss of viscoelastic from the corneal incision, which depressurizes the AC and contributes to corneal striae. Another common challenge is having trouble identifying the angle anatomy structures. This has to do with pre-operative selection. Mastering of clinical gonioscopy skills will help you feel more comfortable with angle anatomy, followed by practice using the gonio prism in the OR. I suggest also for starters to choose patients who have wide open angle anatomy, where the scleral spur is clearly delineated. This will allow for excellent visualization of the catheter behind the TM in Schlemm's canal, both during viscodilation and trabeculotomy or the unroofing of the TM. I tend to avoid patients whose anatomy is borderline open with heavy ciliary body bands or poorly delineated scleral spur. Another important point is to angle the OMNI surgical device tip up about 15 to 30 degrees when initially deploying the microcatheter. This will help the catheter to angle into the Schlemm's canal in the right position and help it to track properly. If you find the catheter begins to turn down towards scleral spur or where you cannot see it, stop, retract the catheter, and angle more upward to then help the tip of the catheter into the right position of Schlemm's canal. Another pearl when beginning your initial incision into the TM with the tip is to not put the inserter tip all the way into Schlemm's canal, but to pull back a little in the same plane, angle up, and then let the catheter glide into the canal. One last important point is to hold the inserter tip steady and press firmly against the TM. By stabilizing the inserter tip, you have much more control in deploying the microcatheter and retracting it back than when the tip is not steady and mobile during insertion. Well, that's all the OMNI Surgical System tips for now. If you found benefit in that review of common errors and solutions for the OMNI Surgical System, please like the video and share with colleagues. We hope this video will help on your journey to MIGS surgical success. Subscribe to the channel so you won't miss the next video in the series. Thanks for watching the Eye Glaucoma YouTube channel, a place for glaucoma innovation made easy for eye care professionals.